What is up, y'all? It's your boy Winston Wolf. I'm back. I just want to do a quick video before I head to work. So I had to run some errands this morning. And I was just listening to movie reviews just to see, because a lot of stuff is going by because I'm just so busy. So I was just trying to find something, you know, maybe that sounded the least bit interesting that I could watch when I get home from work tonight. And this movie, Smile. You've seen it all over the place because they've tried to have, you know, a lot of promotion behind it, a lot of word of mouth promotion. What they're doing is, they're giving a lot of influencers, you know, free tickets, gift bags, all this kind of stuff to try to talk about it, to make it seem like they're actually interested on their own. And these people are finally they're excited because they're finally like, oh my God, I've heard about other YouTube channels and other influencers and people when they get tickets to go see Disney stuff and to meet the stars. And now they sent me a free ticket and one of those little smile, things on a stick with the smile face and, you know, a free t-shirt. So now I'm in there. So then these idiots, these losers feel obligated to speak good about this garbage movie. Everything I've seen about it and all the spoilers I've read, why? There's no monster. There's no main villain. What? So it's just a bunch of people trying to look scary, but they look cringy. That's what you're telling me this movie is. That's what it is. So we're doing this whole Blumhouse thing again, like with those Paranormal Activity movies, where it's just a movie shot. It's not exactly like that, but it's the same principle of they just don't show you anything. They try to make a movie and they try to get these dumb, easily bamboozled people, easily pleased, easily entertained mouth breathers. They're giving them these movies where there's very little effort put into it, but somehow these idiots are fooled into spending money and going to see it and talking about how good it is. Like those Paranormal Activity movies. It was nothing. It was just shot. It was, night vision, shot in night vision. And then they just have a string tied to the blankets. Person is sleeping. They pull the blanket off. Oh my God, so scary. The person is sleeping and a door closes on its own. Oh my God. Oh my, wow. Dude, I grew up watching The Thing, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the good Friday the 13th, the good Nightmare on Elm Street, the good Halloweens. Don't be confused. These, as much as I love Danny McBride, these movies ain't it. These movies, the Rob Zombie movies, ain't it. But, so now we got this wave of horror movies the last almost 10 years now of just where absolutely nothing happens. These studios are getting away with doing the absolute minimum. Do you remember when that whole exorcism movie wave came? And all it was a girl in bed. Same plot for everything. Priest gets called. Our daughter is tripping out. Can you come to... Okay. Priest shows up to the house. Girl is in bed. Green makeup on. That's it. Throws up a few times. Levitates off the bed. The bed shakes. That's the whole movie. Are you kidding me? So we're going to still keep doing this with Smile, where it's just a bunch of dorks trying to look creepy and evil. I mean, I guess that they're making money if people... And this is what I call this Redbox audience. That's who's going to see this. These easily... They'll just see whatever. They'll go, hey, go rent something from Redbox. They'll take anything for, I don't even know if Redbox is a thing, but you know what I'm talking about. It's just straight garbage, just movies for the masses, straight up trash. And they'll just watch anything on there. They'll pick something on there. They'll be satisfied with it. You'll hear from these idiots when you come into work the next day. Did you watch The Exorcism of Emily Rose? Oh my God, it's like, shut up, man. Please, get in a car wreck on the way home. Please, so I don't have to hear you tomorrow. For God's sake. That's how you know we're living in some kind of purgatory right now. That I gotta share my air with these idiots. And I gotta hear them talk every day. Jesus Christ, man. But Smile, this looks... We've reached the bottom basement. We're scraping the bottom of the barrel now. As far as what's acceptable for a horror movie. That ain't it. If you think it's it, you're dumb. Look at me. You're stupid. Your family might not be wanting to tell you because you're related. Your friends might not want to tell you because they're dumb too and they don't realize it because dumb people attract other dumb people. Look at me in my face. You are dumb. You're stupid. You're extremely stupid.